There are two main ways to convert a fraction to a decimal. The first way, if we can write an equivalent fraction that has a denominator of a power of 10, we can use what we know about place value to write the fraction as a decimal. And the second most common way is to write the fraction as a division problem. Remember, a fraction bar represents division, and then through division, we can convert the fraction to a decimal. So looking at this first example of 3/5, notice how we can write this as a fraction with a denominator of 10 by multiplying both the denominator and the numerator by 2. So this would be 6 over 10, or 6/10, which as a decimal is just 0.6. But the other way is to perform division. 3/5 means 3 divided by 5. So in long division form, if we have 3 divided by 5, we can put a decimal point to the right of the 3, and then add zeros to the right of the decimal point without changing the value of 3. And before we divide, we should move the decimal point straight up into our quotient. And now we can divide as we normally do, adding zeros as needed. So notice how there aren't any 5s in 3 because 3 is too small. But if we add a 0, we can think of this as 30. And then if we ask how many 5s are in 30, that would be 6. 6 times 5 is 30. And when we subtract, this difference is 0, which means this decimal terminates. And you can see that 0.6 here is the same decimal we had when we used a fraction with the power of 10. And of course, we can always check this on the calculator. Let's go ahead and do that. 3 divided by 5 does give us 0.6 or 0.6. Looking at our second example, it's not going to be that easy to write the denominator as a power of 10, like 10, 100, or 1,000. So let's go ahead and just go straight to the long division. 7/8 means 7 divided by 8. Again, notice how there aren't any 8s in 7. So we'll go ahead and put a decimal point here, move it up into the quotient, and then add zeros to the right as needed. And when we perform this long division, we either have to keep dividing until the decimal terminates, or it starts to repeat with a pattern. So let's go ahead and add a 0 here, and now we'll ask how many 8s there are in 70. Well, that would be 8, because 8 times 8 is 64. We subtract, this would be 6. So we have to add another 0 and bring that digit down. And now we want to know how many 8s there are in 60. That would be 7. 7 times 8 is 56. We subtract again, this would be 4. Add another 0 and bring it down. Now we have 40. And this is good news because there are actually 5 8s in 40. So we put a 5 here. 5 times 8 is 40. And now when we subtract, we have a 0. This means the decimal terminates. So 7/8 is equal to 0.875. Normally when a decimal is less than 1, you'll see a 0 in the 1's place value. We'll take a look at two more examples in the next video.